This video is provided as supplementary material for courses taught at Howard Community College. And in this video, I want to talk about ordering fractions or arranging fractions from smallest to largest. So let's start with a fairly easy example. Here I've got five fractions: 5 over 11, 9 over 11, 4 over 11, 6 over 11, and 8 over 11. Now, the first thing we notice is they all have the same denominator. And when the denominator is the same, you can tell which fraction is smaller by just looking at the numerators. The smallest numerator will tell you which one is the smallest fraction. So 4 over 11 is going to be the smallest fraction I've got. After that, I'll just look for the next number bigger than 4, and I've got a 5 over 11. So that's my next fraction. Then I've got a 6 over 11. So that'll be the third. After that, it goes to 8, 8 over 11, and then 9 over 11. Okay, so as long as you numerate your denominators are the same, this is really a fairly easy problem. Now let's look at how we do it when the denominators are different. So here, once again, I've got five fractions. They all have different denominators. There's 11 over 20, 7 over 12, 1 over 2, 8 over 15, and 17 over 30. Now, what I'm going to have to do is give them all the same denominator so I can compare them. Looking at the denominators I have, I realize the smallest denominator I could give to all of them would be 60. So I'm going to have to turn the denominator for each one of these into 60. Let's start with 11 over 20. If I want to turn that 20 into a 60, I would have to multiply it by 3. So I'm going to multiply the whole fraction by 3 over 3, which is just 1. So I'm not really changing the fraction. I'm just changing what it looks like. I'm not changing its value. Okay, so 3 times 11 is 33, and 3 times 20 is 60. So my new fraction is 33 over 60. I go on to 7 over 12. Well, I would have to multiply 12 by 5 to turn it into 60. So I'll multiply the whole fraction by 5 over 5, which once again just equals 1. So 5 times 7 is 35, and 5 times 12 is 60. I've got 1 over 2. I'll have to multiply that by 30 over 30 to change the denominator into 60. So that's going to be 30 over 60. For 8 times 15, I know that 4 times 15 is 60. So I'll multiply this by 4 over 4, and that will give me 32 over 60. And for 17 over 30, I'm going to have to multiply that by 2 over 2, and that will give me 34 over 60. So now all the denominators are the same, and all I've got to do is look at the numerators and start with the smallest one. The smallest one I have is 30. That's 30 over 60, and that was originally the fraction 1 over 2. So that means 1 over 2 is my smallest fraction. After that, I go to 32 over 60, and that was originally the fraction 8 over 15. So that's the second one. Then I go to 33. 33 over 60 was originally 11 over 20. So 11 over 20 is my third fraction. I've got 34 over 60. That came from 17 over 30. And then my last fraction, the only one I've got left, is 35 over 60. And that came from 7 over 12. So all we have to do here is find a common denominator when your denominators are different. Convert all of your fractions into fractions with that common denominator, and then compare the numerators, and that will tell you how to arrange the fractions. Okay, so that's it. Take care, and I'll see you next time.